Hello, welcome in today's Life in Thriving Career Month. I'm Sarah, and here at Thriving Career Month, I believe that every mama deserves to live in harmony. I know from my own experience that it can be hard to be that good mama you want for your kids and have a successful career. But here at Thriving Career Month, it's all about helping you, mama. Get clarity in your career path, grow your confidence, and lead a calm living so that you can enjoy your life with your family. Today, I'm talking to you about something. So if you are one of the people that when you hear like about, oh, it's important to network in order to really grow in our careers, in order to get that job and so on, and you when you hear it, like you feel so, oh my God, what I'm going to do? I feel uncomfortable to network with others. And so you are not alone if you have that. And today I'm speaking about this because I also was feeling like that when I get that you need to network, need to connect with others, new people, and so on. And it really makes me feel so uncomfortable. But there is a shift that happened. And I really cannot tell you how life-changing that shift in my life. Because I started really to grow and learn and be more successful in my life. Not only in my career, but in my life. Feeling more fulfilled and more successful. So let's get started. You will first learn about this mindset shift, and then I will also give you some steps that you can go through in order to make this easier for you. So the first mindset shift that needs to happen is, the thing is that from my own experience, as well as most people who feel uncomfortable in networking or connecting, it's like that when you on the act, it's about thinking that when you approach someone to ask for something, it's like you are looking for something for your benefit and your benefit only. And that person is not benefiting anything from you. So it's like taking from the person. And yeah, you are using that person's knowledge without giving anything. And this makes us comfortable because being the taker is not really the thing that we want to be perceived as. So the shift that needs to happen here is about forget about taking. If, for example, if you want to approach the person because you are looking for a job, forget about the job offer that you want. Yes, even though you do want to contact for that person for the job offer. And approach connecting with the other person with curiosity. A curiosity that helps you build connection. A genuine relationship that will create trust, let the person know you. And also, yes, you can also add into that that relationship with the steps you will know how to add into the relationship. But here, now I want you to focus from shifting from that mindset of taking into knowing that there is something that you can give to the person, even listening to the person, even letting that person share their experience. It's something that is a person likes and loves to do. So first, from you are not a taker when you contact someone. Approach it with curiosity. Learn about that person. And when you create that relationship, on the long term, the job will come naturally. Because just think about it. If you are in the position of referring someone for a job. Would you like to refer to someone who just reached out to you and said, like, I'm interested, or someone you know that told you this job offer I'm interested in? Who would you refer, the person that you don't know or the person that you know? Of course, the person that you know, because you want to be with people that you know, that you like, and so on, and you trust. So work on that on the long term and be curious about the other person. The second shift is, which I heard from another career coach, which is like, give others the gift of helping you. Allow them to help you. Just remember yourself, when you love helping, if you love helping others, like me, for example, when we help others, we feel happy. It's like something from the human is like, it's not only receiving that makes the person happy, it's also giving help, making someone's life easier, making another person smile. So that gift of helping, when you ask for help, you are giving the other person the gift of helping you. And that same feeling what you do when you feel that when you help someone. So if you give, you need to also be ready to receive and give that, allow others to gift you that. So these are the two mindset shifts, from a taker to a giver, and approach the new connection with curiosity, forgetting about the thing that you want, like the job offer, but more like building a genuine relationship with curiosity and learning from the other person. Now, let's go into the steps. So I created a first framework for it, which is of three things that are: first, share, the second is value, and the third is intention. Share your value with intention. So what is share? So here I wanted to say that, so I said, like, everyone has a value to give. And it's not only about, like, you need to be advanced in your career in order to share something. No, the thing is, people are wired to want to know that there are other people who went through the same experience, who like the same thing, who share the same goals. So when you connect with someone who you share something with, it's something that the other person will like. So look for the shared things. Connect to a community where there is things you share together. Moms looking for a job. You can say, for example, expat moms, if you are expat. And even not related to your career. For example, you like painting. Like, connect with, share that hobby with others about painting. So it's about sharing in general. Because you have to remember, for me, for example, if I connect with a mom, I feel like I want to connect with other moms. And that's not only for me, for all people, they want to be feel that others have the same experience. The second thing is to know your value. Here, as I told you, like, you have to ask yourself, how can I add value to this person? Because everyone has something to add into another person's life. And the thing here, why I'm mentioning this value, which seems like repeating, sharing, but here it's in a different way. So, because if you are connecting with someone and you don't believe that there is something that you can bring to the other person, then you won't bring it, and they won't believe in you that you can bring value as well. So you need to know your value first, to try to reflect on this before reaching to the person, or even when you are connecting with a person, with curiosity, you can use that curiosity in order to know what value you can bring to that person. So ask yourself, how can I add value to this person? And here, also, I want to say that that's why, for example, it's so important to know your strengths, get clear about your achievements, accomplishments, and so on, because those things will clarify for you what value you can bring. And the other thing is like researching when you are, for example, reaching out to someone in LinkedIn or asking a friend to refer you for another person, looking around and trying to research that person in order to understand how you can bring value to that person is so important. Or also, it can be just when discussing with someone, with this person, and they share that they need something or they are looking forward to something, and you have a resource or you have a reference that you can give. That's also a value. It's not only something that needs to be complicated and so on. Sometimes it's just referring someone to another person or giving a resource is already a value that you bring to that person. The third step is intention. Here, so as I said, the mindset is around building genuine relationship, long-term relationship. It's not about networking. Networking is not about just getting in touch with a person for giving, taking value from it and so on. No, our mindset is giving, building a relationship in the long term. And so how to build that? It cannot be built without intention. So follow up with your new connection. Thank people who help you and offer help. Sometimes for me, it happened. For example, I recently got on a call with another person, and I originally thought maybe I don't have anything to help, but I asked them, is there any way to help you? And yeah, I actually, like, the person told me, yeah, you can help me in this and this because I'm looking for this and so. And it turned out there is a way that I can help. And that's something that makes me happy. And yeah, I mean, have intention to ask that, to offer help. So ask the question, how can I help you? If you don't know, how can I help you? Is there any way to help you? And this will make the person request something that you can help with. And the follow-up here also, I mentioned it because it's so important. Like for me, for example, when it happens to me, I receive I receive a follow-up from someone. It's really, I feel that, for example, I gave a workshop last time, my How to Win Your Job Search in 15 Minutes. And right away, one of the attendees sent me a message and said, like, thank you for this workshop, and it's this and this and this. And I was so happy by that follow-up. The same, when you do it with your new connection, it makes them, you stay in their mind, you are distinguished, because it's not like you are someone who just wanted to connect and have that conversation, and that's all. They feel that you are, like, you are here for a long term, for creating a relationship. So these are the three steps. Share your value with intention. Yeah, and the mindset, from taker to giver, and curiosity. Be curious, learn about the other person, and give them the gift of helping you. That's all for today. I want you to let me know what's like for you. What holds you back when approaching a new person? I really want to know that so I can help you in this. And if you have any question, please reach out to me. See you next time. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye.